कैन आई स्टार्ट सर? राजेंद्रन सर, कैन आई स्टार्ट?
सर
थैंक यू सर। आई होप माई स्क्रीन इज विजिबल टू यू गाइस, एम आई राइट?
यस
Yeah. So yesterday we wind up the session with VLSI design flow, or steps that are relevant with the front end design, steps that are relevant with the back end design. Okay, guys, if you are with any questions regarding the previous topic or yesterday's discussion, yes, I am happy to answer for that before going to today's session. So today is with a bit different stuff we are going to discuss, so continuation only. Okay, I request all the participants, kindly mute yourself whenever it is required, unmute, or else if you are unmuting right now, I feel that there is a question from your side. Okay, it's a kind request, please mute yourself. Thank you all. And any questions or any requirement? Yesterday I was unable to interact with the participants and I was unable to know what you are in need or what you guys are expecting, what we can do, what we need to do, all those things. Okay, I hope today my time slot is right from 6:30 to 8, so during this 1.5 hour what I'm going to teach. So if I know something from your side, yes, I can plan accordingly. Yes, any requirement from your side, anyone? You can unmute yourself and you can speak right now, I think.
Hello, sir.
Yes, sir, please. Your name?
Murali,
you are from?
Yes. Sir, is there any? I am from Vijayanagaram.
Vijayanagaram, good. Which college you are?
Currently, I am studying MTech second year in Sri Krishna Devaraya University.
Good. Yeah. Yes, carry on.
Sir, is there any internship availability in your institute or something?
Yes. We are with. I think you people will get some information regarding that internship. Okay. So definitely, we will help you in that direction. Apart from that, any additional set of questions?
No, sir. I will ask, sir, if there are any.
Okay, good. In fact, we have already finished a couple of internship programs in last month. But currently, I supposed to check, okay, with my team. And you let you know, okay? Let you know about kind of things, what we can do for you. Thank you, Murali. Anyone else? Okay. Anyone else who in need of any kind of information regarding? Yes. Okay, I think I can start my today's session. Welcome back to today's session. This is Aditya. And so based on time slot and based on majority of the participants are from diploma, I just restricted my discussion mostly towards the diploma level. Okay, so doesn't mean that I'm unable to clarify your doubts. Yes, I'm happy to clarify your doubts. And in fact, our basic aim or motive is to glitch you or just ignite you. Okay, and turn you towards the VLSI sector, as it is with a lot of scope or boom. Okay, with good amount of package, with good salary and good number of requirements also. Okay, many people are struggling to get a job in software. Software means like a conventional type of software. VLSI also comes under software, but it's not conventional. Okay, it's like a traditional, latest, okay, trending jobs with a good amount of salaries and good number of companies also eagerly waiting to select people like you guys, provided if you are with enough amount of knowledge if you are with the matching criteria. Okay. So anyway, yeah. So these are the steps we covered in previous today's discussion. Okay. Yes. My objective is I wanted to give the information regarding those steps. Still, I covered only the flow. Still, I covered only the steps that are basic steps that are required. And my objective is to give the justification for each and every step. Yes, if you are not clear, no problem. I'm here to assist you. I'm here to help you to get the clarity on each and every step to get knowledge on complete VLSI design flow. Of course, getting knowledge is a bit different when compared to becoming expert. Okay. So this is, I can say this is a stage where you will understand what is the scope, what are different terms, what is the technology, what is the way, what is the path. Okay. Later on, if you are interested, yes, 365 days, our doors are open to assist you. Okay. As Ramesh Naidu addressed, you'll get whatever the kind of assistance, okay, you are expecting from our side. Clear? Now, so coming to the basic element, or I can say the hero, okay, the hero of the story for over this period of 5 days, okay, training session is MOSFET, metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor, MOSFET. Okay. I'm telling you, this is the hero. I request one or a couple of persons are still need to mute themselves, please. Okay. Of course, you are with your work. I could able to sense it, but please mute from your side also, because I could able to sense all the mouse and key. That working condition also. Thank you all. So hero is MOSFET. Okay. Then, if you are studying about logic gates, yes, you could able to work for its outside behavior. But to change the outside behavior, you need to make a change in the inside behavior of that logic gate itself. What is there inside that logic gate? Yes, MOSFET or such type of structure is there inside your logic gate. Okay, so that what we are calling as a logic family. Logic family. RTL is a logic family. DTL, diode transistor logic, is a logic family. ECL, emitter coupled logic, is a logic family. CMOS is a logic family. BiCMOS is a logic family. CMOS is a logic family. Okay, NMOS is a logic family. Means all these are the things you can make, okay, as internal structure of logic gate by which you can change the actual performance of logic gate. The actual performance of logic gate. Okay, outlet, you are getting a logic gate, inverter or NOT gate, NAND gate, NOR gate, okay, XOR gate. So these are the things we are observing. But internal to that, the same NAND gate can be constructed by changing one type with one logic family, second time with second logic, third logic, fourth logic, and so on. Number of times you are changing the internal structure, external is same gate, but internal, there is a change by that. So performance also change. Okay. If you are concentrating on that element or hero, then you have to define some characteristics of that MOSFET. Okay. One particular element or one particular parameter of that MOSFET is, see here, this is, okay. So this parameter we are calling as a length of the transistor. This parameter we are calling as length of the transistor. Okay. Channel length. We're also calling as channel length. Okay. Or else technology, VLSI technology, what is today's technology? What is today's technology? What is today's latest technology? Okay. So there is a big surprise for you guys. So today I wanted to let you know one point, very, very important point. Okay. So many of the people are still don't know that point. Okay. So this is L, what we are speaking. Channel length or technology or size of the transistor, what not. Okay. Now, for your understanding, just I want to take one example. Okay. One example. What is that example? See here. I supposed to visualize the value. Okay. I supposed to visualize the value. That value is nothing but channel length or transistor size or technology or feature, which is nothing but the only space between source terminal of your transistor and drain terminal of your transistor. These are the only two terminals. In between, there is a small space. Okay, that space we are calling as channel length, transistor size, technology or feature. And what is its value by which we are getting so-called specifications or performance characteristics. Excuse me. Dear participants, please mute yourself. So there is a song also I'm getting. Yeah, thank you very much. Still. Pradeep, can you able to identify? John, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Can you able to identify one person who is not in mute condition?
Sai and Lakshmi.
Yeah, guys, I think I request host, please mute them because I think they forgot to mute. Anyway, see here, just come back to the session. So this MOSFET, we supposed to visualize, okay, what is the size of the transistor? What is the
Aditya, sir, can you unmute yourself?
Yeah, thank you. What is the length of the transistor? What is the size of the transistor by which you are supposed to get the characteristics of so-called logics, digital circuits, or combination circuits, or sequential circuits, or such a big device like a computer. Okay? Then, see, I hope that everyone could able to visualize the particle what I'm showing. Okay? So this is a human hair particle itself. Okay? So fortunately, its diameter is 75 to 100 microns. 75 to 100 microns. Okay. So I think you could able to identify the units. Okay. 75 to 100 micrometers. Microns means micrometer. Okay. For my simplicity, I'm just taking the upper limit. Upper limit of that human air particle is 100 microns. 100 microns. Good. Micron means 100 into 10 power.
10 to the power of minus 6.
Okay. Generally, it is minus 6. Okay. Meters, in terms of meters. But now I'm taking this 100, okay, 100 micrometer as the reference. You just imagine that in your finger. So there is a gap. In that gap, you just imagine that you are holding your hair particle. Boys and girls, dear participants, please try to feel and please try to touch your hair particle. Okay. And the diameter of that hair particle is 100 micrometers. Okay. Now what I'm doing, just I'm truncating that by 100 times. Just I'm truncating that by 100 times. Okay. I think everyone might be knowing what is the real meaning of truncating. Okay. I'm not cutting. I'm truncating means I'm splitting. Okay. I'm splitting that particle just longitudinal. Okay. I'm not cutting that one into pieces. I'm dividing that particle into pieces. How many times? 100 times. Okay. Now the result is 1 micrometer. The result is 1 micrometer. Okay. And this 1 micrometer, I can call it as 1 into 10 power 1 into 10 power minus 6, okay, that is meters, or else 1 into 10 power 3, that is 1000 nanometers. Both are same. Okay, 1000 nanometers. 1 micrometer, which is nothing but 1000 nanometer. Just I'm close to my point of discussion. That's why I'm taking this example. Okay, 1 micrometer is nothing but 1000 nanometers. What is this? So this 1000 nanometer is a particle. Okay, so after truncating your hair particle by 100 times, please try to visualize and imagine it. What is that? Okay, so 100 nanometers. And now to reach my current technology, see here, I just divided that 1000 nano by 1000 times. Okay, 1000 times. Now my result is 1 nanometer. My result is 1 nanometer. Okay. See here, how many times I just divided? One time 100 and the second time 1000 times. 100,000 times I divided that hair particle. Please try to remember, I'm not cutting that into pieces. I'm just splitting. I'm truncating that into pieces. How many number of times? 100,000 times I partitioned that. Now you just feel, what is the remaining particle in your hand? After making 100,000 number of partitions, such a small component or particle, almost invisible component, you could hold in your fingers cap. Okay, I don't know whether it is there or not, but yes, that is physically there in terms of transistor. Now what I can do with 1 nanometer? Okay, what I can do with 1 nanometer, I cannot do. Or else I wanted to take one more 1 nanometer, which is becoming 2 nanometer. Okay, 2 nanometer. If it is 2 nanometer, what I can do? If it is 2 nanometer, what I can do? Means this particle is divided by 100 into 500 times. Okay. But the factor is, recently in the year 2021, okay, recently in the year 2021, here 2021, IBM come up with an IC. Inside that IC, your transistor size or channel length is only 2 nanometer. Only 2 nanometer. Okay. See here, the transistor size is nothing but space between source and drain. Transistor size is nothing but space between your source and drain. What is the recent value? What is the recent technology? What is the current technology of transistor? We need to say it is only 2 nanometer. Okay. But earlier technology, in the year 2016, the same IBM technology was 5 nanometer. Okay. Now that 5 could be able to make it as a 2 nanometer. Okay. 2 nanometer. Then, so what is the advantage of that IC with 2 nanometer? Now, I think every one of you guys are having mobiles, sophisticated mobiles, advanced mobiles, Apple phone or something like Oppo, okay, selfie expert, something like such type of mobiles you are holding. But as the features, more number of features are there with your phone, you supposed to charge your mobile twice or thrice a day, twice or thrice a day. But the point is, if your 2 nanometer transistor based IC was developed, okay, if it is developed as a processor for your mobile, then for you, it is enough to charge your mobile once in 4 or 5 days only. It's a statement made by the IBM people. If you want, you just take a line of 2 nanometer IC by IBM. Type it in Google search engine, then you will get supporting video as well as supporting text also. Okay. Now, this is the, see here. Okay. So 2 nanometer means it's nothing but 4 silicon atoms. Your dimension of 2 nanometer is nothing but 4 silicon atoms itself. Silicon atom size, nothing but 2 nanometer size. So your current transistor size is such a small. You just imagine how many number of transistors you can fabricate. How many number of transistors you can fabricate in a die of standard size. Okay. So because of that, your laptop speed or capability multiplied by 30 to 40 times. You just imagine what is today's 4G, 5G technology and the enhancement of the 4G, 5G technology with the development of 2 nanometer technology. How much data speed, how much data speed enhancement is possible with the 2 nanometer technology. Okay, so that is what is today's enhancement in the VLSI industry, IC industry. Today's technology in the VLSI industry or IC industry. If that is possible to incorporate, yes, everything will change. Within no time, you will get the response from the system what you are expecting. Okay. Yes, this is your IC which was displayed by IBM. Okay, with 2 nanometer technology. What is 2 nanometer, friends? So the 2 nanometer is nothing but the only space, possible space between your drain and source of the transistor, what we need to use to develop logic gates, and that logic gates we are using to develop combinational circuits and sequential circuits or memory elements or such a big systems like computers or your mobiles. Okay. That's about the technology background. Clear? But we people in most of the colleges or industries, we people are working with only 90 nanometer or 180 nanometer. Okay. If you guys are having Cadence tool, mostly 45 nanometer technology is only available to the doorsteps of students. That too, if your college is with a purchased license of Cadence or Mentor Graphics. Okay, having 45 or 90 is a dream even today also in colleges or some kind of student level working experience. Okay, but industry people are working with 2 nanometer or 5 nanometer technology. What is technology? Nothing but size of your transistor. What is the role of transistor? If the transistor is there, and that transistor is used to fabricate logic gates as a logic family. See, this is the process. This is the process. First thing is you have to define specification, and then architecture you have to design. After that, functional you have to check, and you have to verify its circuit, and then physical. Physical means layout, and then layout verification. These are the theoretical steps, and on the left side, practical physical appearance. See here a block diagram description, and here you need to write down the code that what we discussed earlier about the flow. Okay, after that this code will convert in terms of your RTL diagrams. See here, this is the representation of your logic in terms of logic gates. See, one is inverter, the other one is AND gate, the other one is OR gate. Okay, like that, a series of AND gates, inverters, OR gates or NOT gates, something like that. But input side, you are providing your required inputs, and output side, you are expecting the kind of function from that logic. Okay, the same thing you cannot fabricate unless until you are converting something like this. What is this? This is a layout. Okay, physical design. Okay, and this physical design without verification is not good in terms of IC. You have to verify these terms, DRC, LVS, and PECS. DRC means design, LVS means layout versus schematic, and PECS means parasitics. Okay, unnecessary capacitive and resistive components that are coming with your layout or layers that you supposed to eliminate. If you are not eliminating, then you will get unwanted delays, unwanted power dissipation. Okay, see. If you wanted to work with half adder, See here, half adder I can construct by using these two gates, like exclusive OR gate and AND gate. Okay, exclusive OR gate and AND gate. But the point is, someone asking me to design half adder with different speed and area characteristics. Different speed and area characteristics. One thing I can do inside exclusive OR gate, I can change the logic families. Inside this AND gate, I can change the logic families with different logic families. Every time I supposed to get the delay characteristics from the same structure. Okay, so in this structure, I'm working on exclusive OR gate and AND gate. Okay, every time my outlet is same. One is with exclusive OR gate, the other one is with AND gate. But internal to that exclusive OR gate and AND gate, the kind of logic family will differ. What is logic family? Circuit in terms of transistors or MOSFETs. That I will explain also. Okay, that is one approach. The second approach is, still even with multiple styles of logic families, if I unable to get the expected performance from this style of logic, then what I need to do? I have to change my type of logic gate. See here, this is also half adder, but it is not with exclusive OR gate and AND gate. This is with NAND gate only. This is with NAND gate only. Okay, but for your information, NAND gate, I may not get the expected performance, but I am having a scope to verify the internal structure and its performance by changing the internal structure with its performance. Every time this NAND gate build with different logic families, okay, then I'm going to check the overall performance of this half adder. Okay, what I mean to conclude? Yes, half adder with exclusive OR gate and AND gate in many number of types, many number of performance issues, whichever is good, I can select, or else I can go to half adder in terms of NAND gate only. Even that NAND gate internal structure also of different types, NAND by using TTL logic, NAND by using ETS, ECL logic, NAND by using CMOS logic, and so on itself. I'm having different types of logic families. Okay, I can change the type of logic gate, that is first thing, or else I can fix the logic gate and I can change the internal architecture of the selected logic gate. My target is getting the expected performance from that logic in addition with its logic function. Sir, my logic is very good in terms of constraints, but it is not good in terms of expected logic function. No, you are not good designer. Okay, then even still, if someone is not happy with the first style of thing, second style of thing, yes, as a designer, you supposed to submit or show him with the third style also. See, this is also half adder. This is also half adder, but the thing is, here exclusive OR gate, AND gate, here NAND gate. Now it is only with the NOR gate. It is only with the NOR gate. Dear friends, I wanted to tell you one point. Okay, if you really wanted to buy a good, a dress or something from the shopping mall, you are not just enter and you will come back from the shop with a single piece by single look and single observation. Okay, you have to go through different samples. Okay, in terms of color variation, in terms of cloth variation, in terms of thickness variation, in terms of price variation. Okay, like something in terms of physical, something in terms of electrical. Here also, if a person wanted to use your logic, then he or she is also expecting a lot of difference or variations. Then what are the approaches by which you can design or develop logics? Okay, one thing is change the logic families, okay, as a number of times. And the second thing is, if not possible with the logic families, Yes. Any questions from your side? Any questions with this point?
No, sir.
Okay. Okay. So here, this is your approach. Okay. This is your approach. You have to start with the problem and you have to end with the IC. But the thing is, your IC should be good enough to perform as per the requirement and also very small. Because right now, you guys are not happy if you are assigned with a mobile of larger size. If you are assigned with a laptop of larger size, everything is compact, very, very small, small itself. Then how that compactness is possible? Because you are working to design a processor with multiple options, sometimes only small number of gates. And internal to that, small number of logic families. Like that, you have to work out. Okay. So now, yeah. See here. So I wanted to show you the actual process. After finalizing a logic gate, what you need to do? What you need to do? Okay. After finalizing a logic gate, what you need to do? So here, see, this is your logic gate. Okay. For the sake only, I just consider NOT gate. But you just imagine that in place of NOT gate, you are free to select NAND, NOR, universal gates, and OR something. Okay. Basic gates also. Only thing is, you should have some RTL diagram or logic diagram, and you should able to name the gates from the logic diagram. And after identifying the gates, what you need to do or what we can do. Okay. So having that gate in my hand, one thing is I can represent. Okay. I can represent it's a schematic. I can represent it's a schematic. Okay. I told you schematic means a structure or representation in terms of MOSFETs or BJTs. Okay. By which one can construct logic gates. ECL, emitter coupled logic. ECL is a logic family. ECL based NAND gate, I can say. ECL based NOR gate, I can say. Okay. I square L based NAND gate. Means gate is same, but internal structure is different. Okay. And then see, after having the schematic, okay, so to proceed, I may change, okay, I may change its appearance. See here, I may change its appearance like this also. Both are one and the same. Input, okay, input common to PMOS and NMOS. Clear? One terminal of PMOS is connected to VDD and other one is connected to output. One terminal of NMOS connected to output and other one is connected to VSS. Same thing, both are same, okay? But the difference is, with this, I'm getting one type of outcome, and with this, I'm getting one type of outcome. Outcome is not in terms of its function, in terms of its design issue. See here, what I can do? With this, I can construct a stick diagram of this type. I can construct a stick diagram of this type itself. What is the stick diagram? The stick diagram is used to construct a layout. What is my layout? My layout is used to fabricate IC. Okay. From this stick diagram, I can construct this type of C. This one. Okay. From this stick diagram, yes, here I can construct this type of layout diagram. See here, same MOSFET. And this is your representation of MOSFET. This is also representation of MOSFET. And this diagram is called stick diagram. This diagram we are calling as layout diagram. Okay. Layout diagram. Similarly, for this, this is your layout diagram. Now you just compare this layout for inverter and this layout for also inverter. But what is the difference? I think I can say this is occupying a bit less area when compared to this. I think I can say this layout is occupying a bit lesser area when compared to this structure. Okay, this structure means that in order to fabricate this inverter in an IC, this is taking much area and this is taking less area. Okay, if you don't know these two, then you can go with this one or this one. Okay, straight away if you are getting this one, it is okay. But what about this one? If a person only knowing about this one, then is it advantageous? Not. It is not at all advantageous. Okay, every time you must have options, not a single. Okay, if not this, what next? Okay, if not that, what next? Like that. Okay, then from this layout, what I can do? Okay, and as a possibility, I am also looking for third one. Now see, third one. See, this is also same. Okay, same layout means layout for same logic. Inverter, this is inverter, this is also inverter. If this is the schematic, I may get this type of layout. If this is the schematic, I may get this type of layout. But if I work further, if I spend some more time on the betterment, towards the betterment, see here, this is my stick diagram. And with that stick diagram, this is my layout diagram. Now you just imagine which one is getting or occupying lesser area. This one is big, this one is moderate, and this one is very small area of occupancy. Okay, so my point to conclude here is, before starting your final fabrication of wanted logic, you have to try for different type of stick diagrams and different types of layout diagrams. Okay, how can you say, sir, which one is good? Sir, is it good, or this one is good, or this one is good? Just by physical look, you are not allowed to say it. By physical look, you are not allowed to say it. Okay. In previous slide, we came to know that there is one step. That step is called PEX, parasitic extraction. Tool will guide you. Okay. You need to pass this layout through that PEX, and this layout through that PEX, this layout through that PEX. Then you have to compare PEX reports of first layout, second layout, and third layout. By that, you will understand which layout is good in terms of parasitic components. Whichever the layout is offering lesser and lesser amount of parasitics, then you can recommend that layout for the next level of fabrication. Next level of fabrication. Okay, this is about the workflow. Where I have started with a gate. Okay guys, please try to remember, for the sake only I just consider, for your requirement only I consider inverter symbol. But in this place you can take, or you can imagine any type of logic gate or any type of logic symbol. Okay, digital logic. So after having the digital logic in terms of gates or in terms of symbols, you need to convert that into in terms of transistors. Having that logic in terms of transistor, you have to convert that into schematic. Okay, and that schematic you have to convert into layout. Okay, then sir, what we can do with layout? Yes, let me go to that step also. Yeah, see here, is there any relation between this piece of information with the previous slide? So for the sake, I'm just going back. See here, this diagram, you just check this diagram. Okay, one layer and one C-type layer, and in between that. Okay, here now you just try to map the number of pieces with its dimensions with the previous slide information. Okay, so with the previous slide layout diagram, I could able to finalize the one which is giving me lesser and lesser values of parasitics. Okay, lesser and lesser values of parasitics. And if that layout is said to be good, then I'm going to separate different layers, get the layers from that layout. Okay, each and every layer separated, and I'm calling that layer as mask layer or MOS layer. See here, mask layers are MOS layers. Yes. So logic key selected, gate selected, internal logic family selected, schematic selected. Okay. And that schematic converted into layout, layout finalized, layout finalized. And from the finalized layout, I got different layers also. And now what I can do with these layers? Now the point is, I have to take these layers to the fab unit. Now see here. Okay. So during the fabrication, each and every layer is used to fabricate. Okay. Okay. Number of layers you are having, that many number of times you're supposed to use those mask layers to convert that layer into this type of structure. This structure is nothing but inverter in the form of IC. Okay. This is the inverter in the form of layout. And this layout is giving me information about different layers with respect to different dimensions. And taking that reference layout, I'm going to fabricate these components. Okay. Now here, I just explained about the fabrication of inverter, but you are not allowed to fabricate only inverter. Initially, inverter, and then NAND gate, NOR gate, okay? And then small logics like half adder, and then full adder, and so on. You need to increase your level of design. Okay. Whatever it may be, the complexity of the device, you need to understand the physics of the transistor or the electrical behavior of the transistor. Okay. Then only you can change the performance of a logic gate. Then only you can change the performance of a digital logic. Then only you can change the performance of a complex system like a computer. Yeah, see here, this is the actual structure. I think you guys feel that this is a multi-floored building. In fact, this is not multi-floored building. This is an IC, okay? Having that layers, previous slide layers, one can fabricate, okay? See here, horizontal layers, vertical pillars, lot of things, okay? And all these layers with the multiple styles, multiple times, one can fabricate wanted logic in a given specified amount of area. Okay. See, I told you the sequence. Okay. Now, see, this is my inverter, inverter symbol. Earlier, I'm working with a transistor or resistor, but now I'm not ready to work with a BJT or resistor because BJT is with much bigger area. And resistance also with much bigger area, I'm not happy in terms of VLSI. That's why instead of taking this structure for the same function, I'm taking this structure. This is inverter, this is also inverter. But this inverter is in terms of BJT and this inverter is in terms of MOSFET. Okay, after that, see. Stick diagram. Okay, stick diagram. And the stick is only as a base I'm using. And from the stick diagram, this is your layout diagram, okay? Layout diagram, okay? And from this layout diagram, see, these are the layers. Layers. And what I can do, taking each and every layer to the fab unit. During the fabrication, each and every layer is used as a mask layer, okay? And these are the layers, see here. Mask, metal, oxide, silicon. See, in terms of this dimension, these materials are defined multiple number of times. You need to go through oxidation, diffusion, and deposition of different types of materials in order to fabricate your wanted logic. Then only we are getting an IC for the wanted logic. Okay? Yes, any question? Thank you, sir. Okay, so once again, you need to go through the contents. Okay, so here you have to start with logic gates. See, you have to start with logic gates. Okay, so to make your logic gate as good or logic gate as strong, which is good in terms of physical as well as electrical, you have to think about its internal structure. Its internal structure is nothing but logic families. Internal structure is nothing but logic families. Okay, logic families. Different types of logic families are there. Conventional logic families, non-conventional logic families. Conventional logic families are mostly with transistors, diodes, and resistors. Non-conventional logic families are with MOSFETs. Okay, even today, MOSFET is so-called old component. Okay. Today, MOSFET is old component. FinFET, okay, double gated FinFET, like that, so much things, okay. And we supposed to develop AND gate, OR gate, NOT gate, NAND gate, so-called gates, not in terms of transistors, neither in terms of MOSFETs. Now, you supposed to develop your logic gates by using FinFET technology. 7-nanometer FinFET technology. Okay. Who knows that even 2-nanometer FinFET will also come into the market, which is having additional features of FinFET as well as MOSFET. Okay. So after that, after developing your gates with the logic families, logic family means here, CMOS, NAND, CMOS, NOR, only CMOS. Okay. And that CMOS or MOS also old technology. Okay. So after making changes in the logic gates, you need to make changes in the combinational circuits. Okay. And then go to the changes in the sequential circuits. Okay. And you need to compare what is the performance level of a combinational circuit with non-conventional logic families and a conventional logic families. I can say half adder with a NAND gate, but that NAND gate internal structure is a logic family, CMOS logic family, non-CMOS logic family. Both the types you have to check it. And both the times you have to check the delay characteristics, power characteristics, area characteristics. Then only you can make a comment. Okay, you cannot compare your height with a tree. You supposed to compare height of yours with the height of your friend. Like that, the performance of digital logic should be compared with same kind of family, not with the different. Okay. So anyway, so this is for your information. So flow is same, but the component is changing. Clear? I don't think that I can erase this. Someone writing this. Please, could you please erase this? Because it is for me, I think.
Sir, it is not possible for me, sir.
No problem, sir. The one who is writing that, I'm asking. Because it is still looking for me. It is not changing even if I change the slide. No problem. It is light enough. Okay. Clear? Now, so just as a part of revision, please, guys.
It is not possible to erase, sir.
No problem, sir. Even from my side also, it's not possible. Okay. Leave it. So, for the sake, you guys need to understand where you are starting and where you are ending. Okay. Just for the review, I am providing you these steps. And with each and every step, there is a direction. Okay. So, it's not a small process to finish your IC right from the problem statement to the IC itself. Okay. Now you have to define a problem. From that problem, you have to define a truth table. And from that, you have to derive the expressions. So whether it is for a diploma student or BTech student or MTech student or a VLSI design engineer, this process is common. Okay, the amount of time you are spending at each and every stage will differ. And expressions, after that RTL diagrams, after that schematics. I told you that schematics are with pin pads or MOSFETs. And from that schematics, I just explained in my previous slide, after schematic, there is a layout. Now you have to construct the layouts. Okay. Every time, so in the brace, there is a letter called S. Why that S? Okay. Though I wanted to buy a shirt, okay, my requirement is single shirt, but the moment I entered, even though I observed the best quality shirt, okay, exhibited by that shopkeeper, I'm not ready to buy that shirt. I have to go through different samples, at least 30 to 40 samples. At least 30 to 40 samples in terms of cost and quality as well as color. Here also, your expression, if it is single, then single, one problem to one solution. It's not a good thing, okay? One problem to many solutions is a good thing. Means for a single problem, you supposed to derive multiple expressions. Now you supposed to ask me, sir, how it is possible? For one problem, definitely there is a one solution. Okay, but I'm telling you, for one problem, definitely there are multiple solutions. Okay. If that is not possible, then for one application like mobile application, how I am getting different mobile phones? One phone is in need of irregular charging conditions. One phone is in need of regular charging condition. Okay. One is only with capable to handle 2 GB RAM and one is capable to handle 4 GB RAM. One is quad core, one is octa core. How it is possible? Yes, there is a difference in the solution. Okay. Application as a whole application is same, but the approach or the amount of hardware developed or incorporated inside that processor is different. That's why your features, set of features inside your mobile also different. Similarly, expression or expressions, then for each and every expression, there is an RTL diagram. Hence, I'm calling RTL diagrams. NAND-based RTL diagrams, NOR-based RTL diagrams, or else common type of RTL diagrams. I showed you half adder. Half adder is same, but half adder NAND-based, half adder NOR-based, or half adder with exclusive OR gate and AND gate. Here are three expressions. Okay, three RTL diagrams means one problem is half adder, but three solutions are there. Okay, who knows that half adder with NAND gate may be good, half adder with NOR gate may be good, or half adder with exclusive OR gate and AND gate may be good. Okay, if I'm not working with three, I cannot make a comment. As a designer, I supposed to work with all the possibilities. I'm telling you, if you are giving me a single expression or a single problem, I'm sure that I can provide you 200 or more than 200 solutions. But the point is, out of the 200 solutions, I cannot say that how many of these solutions are meeting your requirements. But solutions are 200. Okay. Solutions are 200 means for a single problem, I can give you, if you allow me, I can give you 200 different types of ICs. I'm sure about it. 200 different types of ICs. Okay. So anyway, schematics, layouts, that's the thing you have to look for. One too many. Okay. If your expression is single, from that expression, multiple RTL diagrams. Your RTL diagram is single, from that RTL, you have to draw the multiple schematics. If your schematic is single, from that schematic, you have to draw the multiple layouts. Okay, for each and every schematic, I can tell you there are three layouts possible. There are three layouts possible. Okay, yes, three layouts. Three layouts means three solutions. Okay, I'm telling you from a single schematic. I'm not telling you from a single problem, there are three layouts. Okay, so like that, at each and every stage, you can ask me, sir, why we supposed to look for multiple, multiple, multiple? Yes, if solutions are not multiple, then how can you check variations in the performance of solution or variations in the performance of IC? It's not possible. Okay, let us go through how it is possible. Now, with this process, different checkpoints are there at each and every step. Different checkpoints are there. Okay, so checkpoints are there. The checkpoints are, see, for a problem, first thing is you have to make that problem as a problem statement. You have to make that problem as a problem statement. What is the difference between problem and a problem statement? Okay, so in a simple, I can say design half adder is a problem. Okay, still that problem is with unknown information. Okay, half adder design is a problem. But if I wanted to make that problem as a problem statement, I need to define like design half adder by using NAND gates only. Yes, it is clear a bit. It is a bit clear. Okay, there won't be any ambiguity. The designer straight away will start to design half adder and he is going to use NAND gates only. Otherwise, that fellow needs to use NAND gates, NOR gates, normal gates also. Please mute yourself, guys. Excuse me, guys. Please mute yourself. Okay. So, half adder is a problem, but a half adder with NAND gate is a complete statement. It is clear. Okay. So, as a designer, you have to finalize. As a designer, you have to finalize. One more thing is, if someone asking me to design half adder, okay, I can assign x comma y as input variables, a comma b as input variables, or I1, I2 also as input variables. Okay, just I'm having that level of freedom. What about my output variables? If I assume I1 and I2 are the input variables, Y1 and Y2 also my output variables. But the thing is, if I imagine or assume that Y1 and Y2 are the output variables, who will understand that the functionality of half adder is half adder only? It is not clear. It is not clear itself. Okay. That's why as a designer, it's you need to decide what are the kind of input variables required, what are the kind of output variables required to specify, which should highlight the function of the logic what you are designing. Okay, sum and carry, traditional type of output variables. Okay, even though if you are not assigning sum and carry as the output variables, that half adder itself always acts as a sum and carry. It is always producing its sum and carry as outputs. But if I represent sum and carry as output variables, then public will easily understand, yes, it is a kind of adder circuits. Otherwise, that fellow or public right from the beginning till end. At the end only, he or she will understand, yes, this is adder and it is for addition operation. Okay, now, coming to the truth table, you have to provide exact relation between input variables and output variables. Okay. If you are writing a code for AND gate or defining AND gate, but you forgot about AND function, then it is not giving you any mistake. Okay. But the result is with the error. Okay. Now, so expressions. what is the use of getting expression? Then here I can explain one equation. That equation is, see, I'm having one expression, see, xy plus x, previous equation only, xy plus x, okay, xy plus x only. In fact, this expression can be optimized, okay, and if I'm having time to optimize, yes, I can make this one as x, okay, which is equal to x, which is equal to x. Then what is the difference between this expression and this expression? This expression is with the single variable. This expression is with three variables or three literals, which is taking one AND gate and one OR gate also. One two input AND gate and one two input OR gate. I told you in previous class, it is taking some amount of delay. Okay. What about this one? Yes, without logic gates, I could able to realize the same function. Okay. So this is what is we need to concentrate on, minimization of unwanted number of literals. Minimization of unwanted number of literals. Literals means variables. Okay. So some kind of knowledge, Boolean algebra, Boolean postulates. So those things you have to apply. Okay. K-map, tabulation method, those things you have to apply such that redundant variables or unnecessary variables can be eliminated. Only wanted variables will be there in your expression. Okay. Now, so after finalizing the expression, you are getting your RTL diagrams. Okay. RTL diagrams are normal in form or only in NAND form or only in NOR form also. Okay. Now, so after getting that RTL diagram, you have to convert schematics. You have to convert schematics. I showed you one schematic for inverter. Okay. Then just for your sake, I'm just explaining you one thing. Suppose if I want to work with two input NAND gate, see, for two input NAND gate, this is my schematic. Okay. For two input NAND gate, this is my schematic. See, this is my schematic. This is my PMOS transistor network, my input variable A and my input variable B. Now, pull down network is with two NMOS transistors like this. Yeah. Okay. So, for this to develop, two PMOS transistors required, two NMOS transistors required. Okay. Totally 2+2, four transistors required. Okay. Four transistors required. And area wise, for this CMOS, I need to use six units because one NMOS, one unit, and for PMOS, two units. Okay. So 2+2+1+1, total six units of area. Okay, six units of area. So based on area, again, there is a capacitance. C equal to C naught A means if area is more, capacitance is more. If capacitance is more, then its associated delay also more because tau V equal to RC. R is the resistance, C is the capacitance. Okay, guys, is it clear or not? Based on area, interdependent parameters are there. Capacitance increase. Of course, area occupancy also increases. But capacitance increases. Because of this capacitance, your delay also increases. Delay means circuit delay. Speed decreases. Speed decreases. Speed decreases. Okay. Then, I'm not happy to go with this NAND gate I need, but I don't want to bear this much area and this much delay. Okay. Then I'm going with to the some expert. I'm going to the expert. Okay. As per the expert suggestion, I just developed the same NAND gate by using another type of schematic. See here, this is my schematic. What is my schematic? Earlier, this one is CMOS type. Okay. This one is CMOS type. Now, I'm going to the poly NMOS type. See? This is my schematic for NAND gate again. But the difference is, now, A, B for pull down network. Okay. This is A and this is B. Now, this is also NMOS type. Whose gate is connected to VDD. VDD. Okay. Guys, I'm giving you idea. If you are not happy with this, you can question me. Okay. You can ask me the questions so that I will try to explain. Okay. See here, two number of PMOS transistors are there, but here only one number of NMOS transistor. Okay. Same logic. Okay. Here, this is Z. And here also this is Z. Okay. And here, how many number of transistors are there? Three number of transistors. One unit for NMOS, so one unit of area for NMOS. And this is also NMOS, hence one unit. So total area is three. Okay. Number of transistors are three. And area is three units. Okay. Because of three units area, now your modified capacitance is, how much it is? Half. Half the capacitance of previous. Okay. Half the capacitance of previous. Now, here your capacitance is 3C naught. Capacitance is 3C naught. What about the capacitance here? Here, your capacitance is 6C naught. Because in place of A, I'm taking six units. Okay. And here, as your capacitance is getting down, your tau is also half off. Okay. Half of the previous. Now, same NAND gate, but the point is, it is with the enhanced speed as well as area characteristics, and it is with non-acceptable condition of area and speed characteristics. Now the point is, if you want to increase the speed or area characteristics, then, so this is the way how you have to change the schematics. Okay. This is also schematic. This is also schematic. This is also NAND gate. This is also NAND gate. But this NAND gate is with the higher parameters and this NAND gate is with the lower parameters. Okay. Now, so this is the important area where you can concentrate on capacitance, resistance, delay, number of transistors. Okay, and rise time, fall time, power dissipation, so many things you can change. If you are giving me one expression, single expression, yes, I can give you at least six or seven different types of schematics. Means you are getting a scope to compare with seven or eight different values. Area will differ, okay, delay will differ, and whichever the schematic is good for you, you can go with that to the next level. Okay, what is your next level? Layout. Okay, is any question, please? Yes, you can unmute, I think Jayasri or someone else, you can unmute and proceed with your question. Yeah. Swami sir, is this instruction to me or to someone else? Because I am with one instruction like, sir, is it visible only you can check out.
Sir, someone is asking regarding the visibility of screen.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Yeah, participants, any questions, any clarifications? And someone raised your hand. I'm not getting the point from your side. Yes. Yeah. Thank you very much. Okay. Then, so after making your workout, after finalizing your schematics in terms of transistors, in terms of rise time, in terms of fall time, in terms of power dissipation, thing is, whichever the type of schematic is offering the least amount of capacitance, resistance, and delay characteristics, yes, you need to recommend that for the next level of process, that is layout. Okay. And again, layout also, you can work out with two or three types. So earlier we discussed about inverter layout. Okay. One is exactly same as schematic. The other one is different, bit different. And the last one is quite different when compared to the schematic. Okay. Means layout one, layout two, layout three. So each and every layout you have to check for its parasitics, functionality as well as parasitics. Whichever the layout is with least possible parasitic, you have to transfer that to your GDS. Okay. Test it. And that GDS file is being forwarded to the fabrication unit. Okay. So layout which you need to forward for GDS is DRC, LVS, and PECS. Okay. Now, with schematics, you have to check for the logic families. With layouts, you have to check for the effective stick for betterment. Without stick, you cannot work out directly. Okay. For layout, you have to take the help of stick diagram. And GDS file is a file which is with the mask layers information. Info on mask layers. And now mask layers are for the fabrication and then for the testing. Okay. So testing is used for faults, stuck at zero fault, stuck at one fault. Okay. And then. So for your information, I'm telling you, bit or number of VLSI EDA tools, clear? Front end design tool, see here, Xilinx Vivado. Okay, of course, if your system requirements are satisfying the tool requirement, you can use the web support, okay, for Xilinx Vivado. Only thing is your system must be with compatibility. Okay, Mentor Graphics, yes. This Mentor Graphics definitely open software is not available. You have to purchase. Okay. Then only you can use. And Xilinx System Generator. Yes, it is also a very good tool, handy tool. You guys can work out. MATLAB compatible to System Generator. Of course, MATLAB is also accessible upon registration. And FPGA kits. Okay. Xilinx with Vivado FPGA kits. You can work on these areas, okay? And then coming to backend tools, Cadence or Cadence Virtuoso, okay? Something like, what I can say, Quartus, okay? Some set of tools are there in Cadence also. And then Mentor Graphics, see here, this Mentor is there in the front-end design tool as well as back-end design tool, okay? So up to schematic, you can verify in Mentor front-end tool set and layout, you just get in back-end tools itself, okay? Layout, Mentor Graphics Caliber is the tool, okay? Caliber is such a potential tool to verify your layout characteristics. Caliber is excellent. Okay, handy, good tool, and you can draw the layout, you can verify each and every parameter of your layout before converting that into GDS format. DRC, LVS, and PECS components. Okay, and then for layout extraction and physical verification. Excellent, handy tool for you guys to work out. Okay, and cost point of view, Mentor is comfortable. And one more principal advantage is almost all academic units like to prefer this tool to use. And the point is, if students are aware of or acquainted with this mental graphics, yes, they can use other tools also. Okay, because mostly industry tools are a bit different, like Cadence, okay, and Tanner, okay. But the shortcuts and the basic procedure with the Cadence and the Tanner are almost matching with the procedure of Mentor graphics. Mentor is good for the academic applications, and of course, industry also. Calibre is most dominant in industry also. Calibre means layout extraction and its verification. Okay, and then suppose if you want to do some activities with the help of website only, you are not having installation facility, you are not having some systems, then in the website also you can, I mean with internet also you can verify the functional response. See here, one of the website called falstead.com. okay, I feel that almost 60-70% of your laboratory experiments can be verified in your laptop without go to college, okay, provided if you are with internet facility. Your pulse and digital circuits laboratory, your ECA laboratory, okay, your your VLSA laboratory till the schematic level. Okay, so if you open that website falstead.com, and therein you will get a workspace. Onto that workspace, so you can call some set of components like transistors, MOSFETs, logic families, gates, ICs also you can call. Call the ICs and place that IC, and you just as per your requirement make the connections. And there is a set of source availability. Call that sources and use them. Okay, use them. And you can verify the functional response also. If I am having some time slot, I can show you those things also. Okay, so in addition with that, if any MTech student or BTech student with much interest, you can go through this website also. Very cool. Okay, very cool. This website is making you to work out on open software system. Okay, like Verilog you can work out, System Verilog you can work out. This is about tool sets. Okay, and anyone much interested to use or serious enough to have some VLSI working experience, yes, you are also having bit stuff, okay, good stuff, like Simica DE, DSEH, and the Tanner EDA. So I think these are the tools that are available at free of cost. Only thing is you have to register and download. And Simica DE is a kind of tool which you can verify your schematic response. Okay. Only thing is you have to download. I mean, you have to register over a period of 1 month. Okay. So you can work out in two ways. One is you just change your date in your laptop, or else you have to change your mail ID to re-register and to get the license as many number of times. Okay, but the thing is you can use these number of tools at the free of cost for your working experience. TSEH, digital schematic tool. One more tool is there, like TopSpice, and that TopSpice is also a free tool, but the problem is only 300 or 400 number of components you can use, like your PSpice or something like. Okay, so if your circuit is with more than 400 components, yes, you have to purchase a license. So like that, a different set of tools are available nowadays. Even IIT, NIT kind of things, colleges offering some set of platforms to create interest in the VLSI field, offering working environment at a free of cost. Okay, so this is about tool sets. Let me have the recap on discussed points from tomorrow. Again, we will go deep into these points. So wherever there is a checkpoint, yes, simplify and minimize. That is the object I have to explain. Okay, means what are different approaches by which you can simplify, that I have to explain. Okay, and the output from that step is I am getting the RTL diagram. RTL diagram with the least possible number of gates, that is my expected target. Okay, so after that, this RTL diagram, I have to write the HTL code, VHDL or Verilog code. HTL means hardware description language. Okay, and through this HTL code, I have to get the reports, synthesis reports or summary reports, in which I can estimate how much delay and area required to develop that logic. If those parameters are okay as per my requirement, yes, I can proceed. Otherwise, I have to go back. Okay. Then after this code, my next objective is draw the schematic. Okay. I must show you how one can draw the schematics in different types. Of course, even today, I just try to explain how can we change the schematic to other schematic. Okay. CMOS based schematic to only NMOS based schematic. Like that, I can tell you more than 8 type of schematic for a given logic. Okay. If it is NAND, 8 type of internal schematics. If it is NOR, 8 type of internal schematics. Or else any logic, you can select. You are free to select the type of logic. And I'm ready to provide you at least 8 types of schematics. Okay. And so each and every schematic, with each and every schematic, there is a change in the transistors. Okay. Whichever schematic is in terms of lesser number of transistors, yes, that is good for me, because by which I can save the area. Okay. My next point is I have to draw the layout. Okay. See here, how many checkpoints are there? Simplification is your step. Writing HTL code is your step. And draw the schematic is your step. And draw the layout also your step. Okay. All are the steps that should be carried out by human being only. Manual optimization approaches. Okay. It's you need to do all these things. But what a CAD tool can do, or what an EDA tool can do. Okay, the CAD tool, or CAD means computer aided design. CAD means computer aided design, or EDA means electronic design automation. Tool will give you the confirmation for your step. Tool will give you the confirmation for your step itself. That is the only thing a tool can assist. Okay. If you change some length of the device, yes, make a change and just run that change in the tool, then get the confirmation. Okay, then proceed. If not okay, then go back and make some changes itself. Okay, like that. Please take a snapshot of this slide. And for each and every red color character or word, we supposed to make or discuss for the justification. Okay. I have to give you the information about how to simplify, how to write code, or how to draw the schematic, or how to draw the layout. Okay. Yes, with this, I think I can stop. Any questions from anyone?
Good evening, sir.
Yes, sir. Please. What's your name?
Sir, my name is Raju. I'm from Tanku Polytechnic College, sir, SMVM.
Yes, sir. Proceed, sir.
Sir, can we get any material so that we can refer in our free time?
Yes, sir. Sure, sir. Just I will pass through the channel. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. I think any questions are there from your side, then I'm ready to respond.
Sir, in upcoming schedule, can we expect system Verilog code?
Writing code or system Verilog code? Yeah, in system, I mean, in our schedule, system Verilog code is not there because we are not with that plan, but we could able to explain Verilog codes.
Verilog. Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you. If you need, I can provide you the reference. Okay. If you are interested, you just go through that reference. Anything else? Anything, any questions, any more questions? Yeah. Thank you guys. Thank you very much. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Hello.
Hello, sir.
Yes, hello.
Venu Babu, sir, anything?
Sir, can you share the video links?
I think we don't have the option to share that video link, but okay. I think someone is there to do that activity. Okay.
Okay, but I am trying to find out that in YouTube, but I it is not available. So that's
yeah, I got your point, sir. I got your point. Tomorrow at the beginning of the session, we will address that point, and the person concerned person will respond to your queries. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.